Do your past secrets haunt you? Do you wish to tell them, but something holds you back?
Come back, kid. You have a job to do.
No! Stop! Get away from me!
Stop running!
Is it over? I'm back?
Agent Kidman?
Are we awake?
Hey, you! What's going on? Where is this place?
I'm afraid I cannot answer that.
Are you kidding me? Ugh, waste of time.
Society is wounded. We must have that boy.
But if Rubik leaves with him, there must be some way to stop him.
Do you have any idea why this world is the way it is? Hate. Hate. Ruvik's hate. The man's consumed by it. He wants out! Wants to get his revenge! He wants back what he feels the world took from him.
Who's that? How does he know about Rubik?
Despite our powerful benefactors, with this much collateral damage, it's only a matter of time before people start to take notice. KCPD has been dropping by. A female officer. I don't remember her name. Regardless, the police are not something I should be involved with. Mobius says they will take care of it and make an effort to ensure KCPD leave us alone. Then there is the reporter from the Crimson Post, Ivan. Something or other, he has become a personal annoyance. He barely qualifies as a tabloid journalist, writing cover stories about tales of church sacrifices and other nonsense. But now he's being persistent about the missing patients claim. I'll be damned if he is the man who brings Beacon down. It seems that Reuben could be useful for other forms of problem solving. Perhaps I can interest this reporter in an exclusive interview.
Leslie! If I'm still here, then he must be too.
You were moaning in your sleep. Have a bad dream?
They dragged you into this. But either way, you're mine. To do with as I please.
Sebastian. He must be somewhere else right now. Damn it, he doesn't have anything to do with this.
You should find this useful.
While it is theoretically possible for a host to overwrite themselves on a user, the odds of compatibility are astronomical.
But the boy, Leslie, you're saying he's a compatible subject.
Yes, and based on Ruben's notes, the stem should be able to run with Leslie as its source.
I need you to do tests. Determine what must be done to make him the blank slate we need.
Knew what Leslie was capable of. Damn it, why would they hide that from me? We had a STEM terminal here, on the lowest floor. If Leslie's in here with me, he's probably headed there. And that may be my way out of here. I can't get through with the power out. I've got to get things running again. Barely see anything in here. Chemical lights. Better than nothing, I guess. must be a way to get the power back on.
Systems were previously shut down incorrectly. Each terminal requires manual restoration. Please be patient.
This isn't the time to make me wait.
Although brilliant, Reuben was quite insane. A compromise of ethics on our part. He seemed motivated, obsessed with revenge against something never specified. We discovered what he was doing in secret. Torturing. Penchant for traps. A serial killer masquerading around as a scientist.
pathways are shut down until system is rebooted. Thank you for waiting.
His demeanor has turned far too aggressive and his techniques even more perverse. Da Vinci would dissect corpses to further his anatomical studies, but what Reuben has done goes beyond demanding his subjects be aware as he dissects them to truly see how the mind reacts. He's more of a butcher than an artist. But we must remain scientists above all. I had taught him from a young age that the end shall justify the means, but I could not have predicted things to be this extreme. Mobius has learned of his involvement due to my carelessness. I've asked they bring him on board to assist in development, perhaps offering him better facilities and support will refocus him and stave off his gruesome proclivities.
This machine was designed for me. People like you, you took my life away, turned me into an abomination. Finally, with this machine, I can go back. I can live the life I was supposed to have.
We are forgiving. We are willing to overlook your certain peculiarities for what you can provide us. But you are testing our limits, our manpower. Our resources are not here for your pathetic fantasy. You will reverse the calibration on the machine so we can use it without you.
And what if I say no? You think Jimenez can fix this? You need me, and there's no way around it.
Ruvik. No. Reuben. This was where he was doing his research with us. We were just using him. And I doubt he's the first.
Restoring security clearance. This may take a few moments.
I don't have time for this.
System ready.
Damn it! Shit, it's back!
Oh. Please enjoy this music while waiting.
You've got to be kidding me. Come on.
Thank you for waiting. Have a productive workday.
Guess I'm all right for now.
Out of this, Jimenez. He brought this upon himself. We gave him a chance.
Where is he?
If you really wish to know, he's in the next room. Come, see.
This is despicable. What is this monstrosity?
despicable? Coming from the man using his own patience to further his own research?
This whole project, from the beginning, it was about deceit.
Done to him, and I am appalled. To think the young boy I mentored is now this, a mass of gray matter in a glorified test tube. Could they have been planning this all along? And what have I become in all of this? They've managed to keep his mind alive by simulating an artificial body. His consciousness is being confined to a mental straitjacket, a gear in their infernal machine. They have even stricken his name in humanity, referring to him by an anagram, Ruvik. A crude joke, as if spitting on his grave. I almost felt the urge to smash the case and end it right there. But my anger was quickly replaced by scientific curiosity. Reuben's legacy will live on. I will spearhead the next step. I will create something of my own out of this tragedy.
What you see here is one of the first STEM prototypes.
That sound in the patrol car must have been when Jimenez activated it. Joseph, Sebastian, Oscar, they were all going with me. The STEM and Beacon, that's where it all started. There must be a way to get out of this world from there.
There are some things here that are to remain in the dark. Especially for you, kid. You're asking too many questions, ignoring your mission. Running from responsibility. Just like you always do.
No, that's not true! You don't know me!
That much is obvious. But we need to make sure you do what you're told.
You're lying to me, hiding things. I can't trust you, not like this!
You are not required to trust us. Only to obey.
You were assigned to your team for a reason. Castellanos, Oda, they know nothing. But they're searching for answers.
Searching for us, you mean?
One of us. But this may be our chance to remove them. Having all of you in one place will provide us with opportunities.
Listen, the police department. Why am I here?
How's Lily doing?
Great.
This looks like it's way before I got here. Everyone's so much younger. But Sebastian's profile didn't say he was married. Let alone a child.
Look, Seb, we need to talk. Going off with your conspiracy theories? You're getting out of control. You don't pull that in front of the captain.
His daughter, then his wife? One right after the other? No wonder he always seems so closed off.
Julie Kidman? She barely has any experience, and we don't even know anything about her. Send her out, Kim.
Sebastian. He and Joseph weren't supposed to be involved. It shouldn't have happened like this. This is Crimson? This can't be real. The light.
A stellar prototype at Beacon.
Beacon. I just hope I can get there before he does.
Thank you.
he's not coming back. Beacon is close. Can't stop now.
Well, here's where you'll be living. The view's pretty spectacular, huh?
Holy shit. This is different than I'm used to. If you saw where I grew up.
The past is over. You're with us now. Here are the keys. It's yours. You'll have to take care of your own food, clothing, and incidentals. But your bank account has more than enough to take care of that.
So, that's it? What am I supposed to do?
Whatever you desire. But your assignment at the Crimson City Police Department is precedent to everything. You are a police officer, and you must live as such, and act as such.
I don't normally say this, but thank you.
You shouldn't be thanking us. These aren't gifts we provide. You have a very specific assignment at KCPD, and all of this is in exchange for that.
Okay, you're right. Sorry.
Don't apologize. Just show us you can do your job.
You said I shouldn't be, but I am thankful. I don't know what would have happened to me if you hadn't brought me in.
The mark. Looks like it might be my only way out.
This is your last chance to prove yourself to us, kid. Don't let us down. Bring the boy to us.
Stop it! Get out of my head! Dragged you into this. What have I done? Did Ruvik send you? Well, I hope he gets the message.
Kidman! Are you in there?
Sebastian?
Save it for later. There are probably more of them around.
Sebastian? What is...
Stay back. She's my responsibility.
Sorry for putting you through this. I don't want to hurt you any more than I already have. He might try to stop me through you.
A little hasty with that gun, kid. What is it you plan on doing?
What I have to do.
No! You do what we say. You will come back with that boy, or you will disappear.
Find out.
Shit!
What are you doing? Answer me.
Can you discern between evil and good?
No, no, no! Damn it! Fuck!
Kept here.
What the? Maybe I can burn through it.
risk it. Hold on. I think I see another way down. I'll meet you on a lower level.
At least they're all right. Please, just stay out of my way.
After surviving the fire incident and subsequent abuse from his parents, it's a miracle Reuben can function at all. His work comes from a place that isn't motivated by fear or money or social standing. His motives are more pure. I would say that he is obsessed with the chance to relive and remold reality so he can be with her again. His scarring is heavy, both physically and emotionally, but he longs for his lost sister. His love for her borders almost on an incestuous level, but as long as it provides motivation, so be it.
Ruvik's trying to take control of him. Maybe I can stop him.
Thank you.
I am in control.
Holy shit. Maybe I can stop Ruvik then.
I revisited the Victoriano estate yesterday. It's a vestige, a mere husk of what was bound to be such a home of promise. Mobius reaped nearly everything of value when we took on the research ourselves, but Ruben's notes indicate he was involved in something else. There were plans for another STEM prototype. Data about using receptors to transmit the brain function wirelessly to unaware users. It's borderline parapsychology, but these schematics and the scientific backup provided seem sound. What was he planning to do with such a thing? There's only one way to find out for certain, but I must continue these experiments in private, away from their prying eyes. I will not let them know, lest they take this from me as well.
of them.
Keep me here.
It's all right. Everything's gonna be fine. I hope. Not safe. Hurry! This way! Bastard doesn't come back. For your sake, Leslie.
Leslie can go home. Can take the train all the way home?
No, Leslie. Not today.
You'll protect me?
Yes. That's my job.
Good, good, good. When I get home, they'll be surprised.
Understand. You don't know what he'll become.
We know exactly what he'll become. That's why we need him.
You don't understand what Ruvik is after.
Rubik is a corpse.
He's after Leslie.
And so are we. And you're more afraid of him than us?
Don't patronize me. I have orders. But I can't let him have this boy. Leslie is the only one who can... Shit. He's too far gone. I've got to stop him.
Answer our questions. What are you afraid of? What could haunt you so? What could you need that only we could be the ones to fill it? Was your waste of life something you wish to return to? Are you not grateful for what we've done for you? We let you into our circle.
No!
We
Shut
gave
up
you
and
a
get
new
out of
life.
My way!
patients are dying when connected to the machine? What are you implying, Jimenez?
After what you did to him, now all of this is just conjecture. But it's as if Ruben...
Ruvik. He was in STEM all along. Well, he's not gonna get me.
Impatient with our progress and demand briefings on the development process, at first stressing the results, but now they work off a timeline based on their needs. Typical bureaucrats. I've been pushing Ruben, but he's retreated further, doing his research at home and refusing to come to the lab unless it's directly working on our STEM prototype. I'm feeling uneasy, and no doubt Mobius is looking on us with question. We need someone rational inside STEM. Potentially that person could neutralize Ruben. I mean, Ruvik. With my knowledge of the system, I may be of some...
Absolutely not. We can't afford you complicating this any further. We will prepare one of our own.
Sending someone inexperienced, we can't even be sure they can come back.
Then it will need to be someone expendable.
Expendable. So that's how you see me. And I trusted you. Where am I now? Sebastian was here? Enough of this shit.
Disappointing, kid. Such a simple mission, but still, you act out. Thankfully for us, there's always a backup plan. Not everything we give you is for your benefit.
The infusion. What did you put in me?
We needed to know if one of us could survive in the system. But we're not about to risk anyone of value. You were sent to carry us in with you. So here I am.
No. It's Rubik. He's making all of this.
Please, roll up your sleeve.
Whoa, now! That's a big syringe. Don't think you're putting that fucking thing in me.
Miss Kidman, you agreed to this. Don't forget that. Nothing we're doing is malicious. It's only proper protocol.
You know what's proper protocol? Telling the person getting the fucking shot where the hell she is and what's the fucking point. Ow! Damn it! That hurt! Hey, guys, what the fuck? Is anyone there? You give me a shot, then just let this weird video play on repeat? Some great fucking medical science you've got going on here.
About damn time. All right, can I go now?
Not right now, Ms. Kidman. How are you feeling? Any headaches? Nosebleeds, perhaps?
What? No. But I do feel a little floaty. Almost like I'm underwater.
That's consistent with the effects of the compound. We just have one last part of this test to partake in. Then you will be free to go.
Sure. Go for it, I guess.
Good. I will now ask you a series of questions. You will answer them while watching the images in front of you. You will not look away from the screen. Do you understand?
Yes.
Question number one. Have you ever felt abandoned by the ones you trusted?
Choice of your own free will. We were the only ones who cared. The ones who took you from your useless life. We gave you a reason to exist. And how do you thank us? By destroying our work? Where will you go when you leave us, kid?
Everything. They even know about Leslie. There's no use hiding this anymore. I'll enter the system and my return will be proof that all of this was worth it. I can, of course, convince them that it wasn't for me. It was for their goals. There are just the final tweaks left. Once I finish, I will put Leslie in the stem with myself and activate it. The wireless signal should ring out in the near distance. I can't speak for those unfortunate to be around. But like I always said, the ends will justify the means. Finally, Mobius will see that I am one of their chosen ones. Reuben is but a ghost. I am their savior. Their plan is nothing without me. Don't answer our questions. Is it out of fear?
Fear is such a subtle thing. But when one experiences true fear, is when they can be controlled. They can be molded. STEM is an abortion, a machine designed on the premise of fear. But in a sense, it is perfect for what we hope to achieve. You will be the first. You will bow under this fear, or you will die. You will serve as an example for what we will become.
This is me. I'm connected. Just like everyone else. I'm getting out of here.
Sebastian, get away from him. Sebastian, listen to me. Stop. Your interests are the same as ours.
Look, I get it. You're not just some rookie detective, and this is not just some ordinary kid. You killed Joseph and you shot me. So right at this moment, that's enough reason for me not to trust you.
You're a good man. That's why I... It doesn't matter anymore. If you know who this kid is, if you know anything, you know why he can't be allowed to live.
Bullshit. It's Ruvik. He's the one that... Stop.
None of this is real. You aren't real.
You want to believe that, but I'm right here. I've been with you this whole time.
This world is a nightmare. But I'm not afraid of you anymore.
That just shows how little you understand. You should be very afraid. We have you, kid. And you know the consequences for failure. We won't let you just leave us. You fulfilled what little use you have. This world is a prison for you to rot in.
Fuck you. I've had enough of this. I'll kill you right here.
do you see?
It's a shame you'll never see what we accomplished.
Think you've won, but have you? You don't know anything. I am with you. I will always be with you now.
You don't know me. I'm stronger than you think.
Are you sure enough in yourself? Sure enough to face the responsibilities of your actions?
How the hell?
Agent Kidman, we've got him from here.
How long has it been?
37 minutes since the first pulse.
How did we get here?
What are you talking about?
Just give me a minute. I need to get my head straight.
Myra! We need you back here.
All right. But we've got word he wants a debriefing as soon as you get back.
Failed, but they didn't count on you. I owe you one. Welcome back to the real world, Sebastian. I hope you find what you're looking for. Leave that one. And those two. They're not going anywhere.
No one is.